Anderson connectors are a great way to add modular branch circuits to your camper van or RV conversion, and teaching you some tips and tricks revolving wiring them is exactly what we're going to cover today in lesson number 7 of this branch circuit playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Now, before we get started, there's a couple prerequisite pieces of information you need to know, like cutting wire, stripping wire, crimping terminals into wire, but we've already covered that in a specific playlist of this academy, so go back and review that if you don't already know how to do this part. And lastly, before we get started, the fuse block that we're using in this particular demo is the Blue Sea blade fuse block. Now, there's several different types of fuse blocks on the market, like the Progressive Dynamics fuse block, the Blue Sea Safety Hub, the Tiger Expedition UFO 200, and all of those are realistically going to be connected in much the same way. They're all getting their power from a different distribution hub, like the Victron Lynx distributor, which is getting its power from the battery. But we're going to skip all of that side of the system and focus mainly on how we get power to the rest of the branch circuit. Let's get started. Now, I've already taught you how to crimp Anderson connectors onto circuits and wires in a previous video. So if you haven't seen that, go check it out. We'll link to it in the video description below, because today we're just going to talk about the actual circuitry and why you would make some of the choices that you would make. Now, we use these in our show, the Explorist Life show transit van that we built 2-3 years ago, and we did this and it worked great. So with these Anderson connectors, we can use this wall port here. It comes with a nice trim ring that goes around that. This just gets mounted into the wall, and then you can plug whatever circuit that you need into those, whether it's lights, a water pump, a refrigerator, anything like that can be plugged into these. So this lives in the wall, and then you could remove whatever circuitry you need to after the fact. So for us, for example, we did these on all of our upper cabinet lights. And the way we sort of did that is we ran two separate circuits to the two different sets of ports that are on this Anderson connector here. And the way we have that wired up here is we have negatives going to the black terminals here, nothing crazy there, just straight across. And then one of them we have going to the positive without a switch. So that one of these is constant power. So this one here, this upper one is the constant power Anderson connector. Now the other one is switched power. So I just put a switch in line, just a simple toggle switch in line between the fuse block and this Anderson port on the top. And sort of the reason we could do that is, you know, if we had like a refrigerator that had a on-off switch just right on it, we could plug that refrigerator right into this Anderson port like so, and it's always going to have power. Just pretend this is a refrigerator. Always going to have power. Now if we wanted to power lights or like a water pump or something like that, we could connect our Anderson connectors from our load into the other two ports, and that is our switched circuit. So we have one circuit that's constant power and one circuit that's switched power. And that's realistically like how we did that. And you can put multiple of these Anderson connectors on the same circuit like we showed with USB outlets and 12 volt outlets earlier in this playlist. So go check that out if you want to know how to add multiple of these Anderson connectors into the same circuit. It just takes, you know, some lever nuts, and that's pretty much that. So go check that out if you need to know more about that. But that's pretty much all there is to know about these Anderson connectors, and more specifically, like why you may want to connect one to a switch and one to constant power. It's just so you can have that modularity and flexibility in your circuits. So in the next video, I'm gonna step away from Anderson connectors for a bit, and I wanna teach you how to tap into a different circuit, specifically a headlight circuit for powering a relay for like off-road lighting or something like that. So click up here to watch, and I'll see you over there.